Hello, everyone. Welcome back to another episode of Lloyd's ASMR. Tonight, I have a special video for you and me. Recently received a package in the mail from one of you, one of my amazing subscribers. This package came all the way from the United Kingdom. Opened the package, I was surprised that what was in it actually survived the journey, but it was well packaged. So what did I get? Well, I got two very large bottles of beer from the United Kingdom. That's the first one. It's second one is called Cheshire Chocolate Porter. So the first one here, the Cheshire Chocolate Porter, is 6% volume. Brewed by Frederick Robinson LTD at the Unicorn Brewery, Stockport. Specially brewed for Marks and Spencer. And the second one says brewed by Harbor Brewing Company, Bodmin, Cornwall. Classic IPA brewed with Cornish spring water. And this is 5% alcohol. Now, if you take a look at this, right, these bottles are so much larger than the puny little beer bottles we get in the United States. Or at least it looks like it is. I'm pretty sure it is. Now, I also received a letter with this package. And I'll read it for you. It says, "Hello. This is just two bottles of ale from the UK. The first, a chocolate porter, is a traditionally dark ale brewed in a town called Stockport in the county of Cheshire, which is near Manchester in the northwest of England. The name Porter is believed to have originated from the local where the first drink of this type was made, in London. It was originally made up of three parts, one third each of beer, ale, and strong beer. It is believed to have been a favorite of porters who labored at the local market and became porter beer. You will find it a rich, full-bodied beer with sweet overtones, giving it a distinctive bitter chocolate flavor. You should be able to get a good hint of the malt underneath with a long warming finish. You may not get the coffee finish you get with some stouts, but you may pick up on a warming hint of tobacco. The second ale, Cornish IPA, is brewed in St. Austell in Cornwall. You should find it crisp, hoppy, and full of flavor, quite a tradition English ale. I recommend drinking both of them cool, but not cold. Imagine them being left in a cellar. If you are used to drinking cold lager beer, this could be alien to you. But if they are cold, you lose some of the flavor and complexities. Think of this as not thirst quenching, but a flavorsome and rounded. I hope you enjoy them. They are a very small token of my appreciation for the work you do and continue to do. Your videos are relaxing and entertaining. Kind regards, Elliot. Well, thank you so much, Elliot, for sending these two beers. Always pleases me and makes me very happy to hear how much folks like you enjoy the videos that I come up with and make. And it's also so amazing to hear all the stories about how much my videos actually help people in more ways than one. And we're talking sleep, tingles, just general relaxation, all the way down to anxiety, depression. The list goes on, and it is just amazing. So thank you, Elliot, for sending this gift. And thank you all who are watching for being you, for being the amazing, supportive subscribers that you are. You guys are seriously the best. Okay. So, let's start with first one.
I actually have a glass here. That way we can get some pouring sounds of the liquid, as well as some bubbling action. And then I'll put it close to the microphone. So you can all hear. Okay. So the first one would be the chocolate porter. So, yeah. Smell this. And right off the bat, get the strong flavors, the strong aromas coming right out. I smell it really good. Let's pour some. I hope you can hear this. So, it's definitely a pretty dark beer, full of aroma. This is going to be good. Cheers. Here's to you, Elliot. And to the rest of the subscribers out there who are watching right now. Wow. That's good. I definitely taste the hops, but it's not an overpowering hop flavor. It's definitely very full-bodied, that's for sure. I taste the bitter chocolate flavor. It's like some dark chocolate got shaped into it. Smell it as well. Definitely has a chocolatey scent. I do pick up on the tobacco flavor, and just a hint of coffee.
Let's open up the second one. Try that out. All right, so this is the Cornish IPA. And this here is a more hoppy flavored beer. So this will have a bit more of a floral taste to it. Okay, let's open it up. Another nice hiss. Strong of a floral scent as I thought. And there is a slight floral scent. Let's pour a glass. I just love the popping of the foam. Okay, so as you can see, this is a much lighter colored beer than the last one. And over here, take a look. See, much different. Even though I poured it, it still only has a slight floral scent. Cheers. That hits the spot. It's very crisp and zesty. It really gets the taste buds going. It's pretty good. Pour a little bit of each one here. Like 2 cups. Okay, so as you can see, there there's a big difference. This is the Cornish IPA, and this is the Cheshire Chocolate Porter. You can tell the difference. Definitely, big difference. So, I hope you all enjoyed this video. I hope it could help you all fall asleep or just relax and take the edge off the day. Thank you again, Elliot. I definitely enjoyed these beers. Till next time. This is Lloyd's ASMR.